Compiler design happens to be one of the fundamental topics taught as part of the computer science curriculum. And the idea is quite straightforward. First of all, it's a pillar for implementing software. But more importantly, from an outsider's perspective, it is one of the most common use cases of using algorithms and data structures. Because compilers as programs or even interpreters, so when one sees compiler design, it doesn't mean only strongly typed languages. It is basically how to interpret languages into binaries. So the tools for doing language translation into executables is compilation process. So understanding that and implementing algorithms and data structures happens to be the complete use case altogether. So it is building a sophisticated program, and you learning to do so will give you a lot of hands-on. So it is a use case you should be considering to explore. In case you happen to be someone from non-computer science background, then ideally you should be addressing compiler design within the first 4 years of your career, because it can be a little tricky to learn it later, but learning it too early in your journey as a non-computer science graduate can actually make you feel overwhelmed by the amount of information. So in the next segment, we will see how to narrow down the scope, but doing it early part of your career as a programmer will definitely add a lot more value to your thinking process while implementing software more than anything. So try to target it early enough in your career. So let's look at what exactly you need to learn to be sure that you understand whenever a compiler design kind of a problem shows up. So the elementary automata theory, it is also known as theory of computing. So the reason I'm mentioning it as elementary is that just understand the functional aspects. The mathematics can become overwhelming if you're learning it on your own. So in case you are taking a course in a university, then you have a guidance of an instructor, and that is a safe environment to take that risk. But if you are doing it offline on your own, then just understand the basic aspects. So basically the regex which we write, like A dot star B, which means that anything which starts with A and ends with B of any length in between is represented by A dot star B. That is actually a language in itself. And that's what automata theory explains you, that why certain things can be a language and why certain things cannot be a language, because certain expressions can be misinterpreted as something else, right? So that's how languages are constructed, and they define if a particular language can actually be implemented or not. So it is kind of mathematical in nature, and you will find yourself a little out of place while dealing with it at first. So it might take a couple of parses, but it's fine. Just do it once in your life and you will remember it forever. It is that kind of a knowledge. You don't have to visit it back again unless you are actually implementing something, but it is something worth investing time in. The next one is stages of compilation. So basically you are answering how the text you write in an IDE gets converted into a executable binary. And that's all you need to understand. So that is a very straightforward kind of a procedural knowledge. You don't have to dive deep, but you will discover a lot of algorithms and data structures along the way. So that is like you take the notes in the first parse and then you dive deeper. And that's what the third part speaks about, which is implementation challenges in detail. Like how do you parse an information? Right, so we see a lot of languages have some kind of a termination criteria for a statement. It is mandatory. Some languages use a semicolon. Languages like Python use a tab spacing. So there is always a criteria that how do you mention that a line has ended. Otherwise, it will be like infinite thing, right? We have a full stop in English to say that a sentence has ended. If everything was written in lowercase without any punctuation, how would the world interpret anything? So then comes the expression tree, things like garbage collection, or whenever you see a compiler error or interpret, basically you always see a compiler error around things like this particular variable is not defined. You just declared it and now you are trying to use it, but the compiler doesn't know So those kind of situations are based on expression trees, right? The program has been parsed and a certain context has been built. So how are these things working? That is what you need to understand from the compiler design theory. And that makes you a better programmer. Trust me, it will give you a far more nuanced perspective. Things will become part of your muscle memory. And you don't have to force external things. You just start thinking in terms of blocks, code blocks, and scopes. And you just start becoming a better programmer because you are looking at a far more sophisticated program in terms of a compiler. So investing in that basic aspect of converting a particular language into an executable is a great learning journey you need to invest in. The fundamentals which I mentioned about the functional automata theory, parsing, expression tree, etc., that particular knowledge takes around 16 weeks to become proficient in the first parse. So focus on it when you have time available. Ideally, you should be able to do that within like the second or third year of your job because you have a much better handle on your routine. And focus on doing it once, doing it right. So if you haven't understood something, just spend time on understanding it before moving forward. It is not about getting a course completion certificate from a platform. It's very easy to get a course completion certificate. If you cannot implement it, then that certificate is of no value. So focus on doing it once, doing it right. Even if it takes longer than 16 weeks, it's perfectly fine. But once you start it, take it to a conclusion. Don't leave it midway because you'll have to start again. It is that kind of a knowledge that it's correlated and it depends on continuity. If you go from start to end, it will just sink into your memory and it will get etched into your memory. You don't have to work hard to remember it. It is so logical in nature that it just clicks. It just needs to be in your memory and it will click. But if you haven't understood it, trust me, there is nothing more difficult to understand. And also things like dynamic programming are part of compiler design. So don't think that it is something very theoretical and esoteric, which is not applicable in real world. In fact, it is one of the most executed data structures use case you will see. Because every line of code you write, you are going to compile. Everyone is compiling something or the other, right? So just look at it from a very practical perspective. Don't get worried about the things looking complex. They are straightforward. They might require a couple of iterations, but just persevere through it and you will get it. When it comes to compiler design, learning it the academic way is the best way of doing it. So there are lectures on YouTube. Again, as I mentioned, that should be your first place to find information on this front. Find a good university course which has, they will have around at least 20 to 25 lectures and they will tell you which sections they are covering from which book. So one of the most recommended books is something called as the Dragon Book for compiler design. It is a excellent book. It is kind of short, but it is very dense. So you need guidance to walk over that book and you need not understand the complete book. So that's where the course will come into equation and they will help you out on that front. I cannot connect to those resources because of proprietary reasons of platform limitations, but I will try to link you up through certain external resources as soon as I can. But one reminder is don't just buy the Dragon Book and study it on your own. You will feel lost and it is not worth taking that challenge. And don't learn it from some interview portal where some half-baked knowledge is there. I cannot guarantee you that just by typing a certain thing like expression tree, whatever link you get is the right link. That's why I'm recommending go through the curriculum way and do it once, because as I'm recommending, do it only once. So it's best to invest in the best knowledge. Even if you can get a paid course somewhere which is affordable on one of the learning platforms from universities, go for it. Don't go for a non-academic course. the standard of mathematics required is best coming from an academic, not from a practitioner engineer like me or someone else. The knowledge from compiler design becomes helpful in two scenarios. First is writing data parsers for your programs, and the second one is creating domain-specific languages for work projects. So they are kind of interrelated. So the first step for writing any language is writing a parser for it. So sometimes what happens is you have a certain proprietary data format, or it is not even proprietary, but certain semi-structured data, like it has a certain number of columns which is known only to the people who are using that data, right? It is not like a fact, a mathematical fact or something like the number system that two should always come after one, and those kind of relations don't exist, right? So it is just a set of columns. Now, parsing them is a known procedure, and you have to write a parser for it that if the fifth column is accepted, then it has to be an integer, right? So when you are writing things like this, it becomes structural decision making that if data is not present here, then a zero needs to go there. If it is a string, then a null string needs to go there, right? So these kind of decisions is what compilers also make. So writing parsers is a right place to take ideas from compiler design. And if you're creating domain-specific languages, so if you write a certain logic on top of this, like if the fifth column is empty, then the seventh column has no significance. Or if the fourth column has a certain value, then the fifth column needs to be so and so value. So decisions like these are rules engine, and they can be converted into a particular language. For example, if you look at the database language standard of SQL, that is what it defines, that you create a table in this particular format. So SQL is a language standard. SQL in itself doesn't exist as such. Everyone implements SQL. Databases implement a SQL. So you can write your own query language for your domain as well. So that's where knowledge from compiler design comes into equation. And it is a great opportunity to figure out if a domain-specific language can solve a problem faster than a bunch of functions. Because if you can provide a language specification to the developers of a company saying that this is our language of getting things done, then you create a very nice abstraction for the rest of the logic. Then the implementation of an operator can be very complicated, performance-heavy code, which only a few bunch of people know, and it sits inside a library. Like we noticed in the earlier example around data science, that the Python library is abstracting out so much information. You might not even know if the GPU is from AMD or it is from NVIDIA. Does it use CUDA libraries or is it running on Intel hardware? Everything got abstracted out because there is a Python wrapper sitting there which provides you a nice abstraction. So identifying these kind of problems is something which you will realize only after learning compiler design. So that is your opportunity to identify places to apply this knowledge based on compiler design. Like I mentioned in the case of parsers, if you are working with proprietary data formats, then you will definitely benefit from the knowledge of compiler designs. Or if you can create a proprietary data format instead of some semi-structured things, like if there are a lot of decisions being made based on CSV files and the kind of information in different columns, then try to formalize them as a single header which defines that this file contains this particular format, and then parsing becomes easier. So you are writing a small kind of a parser language over there. And again, if you see domain-specific logic getting repeated as multiple functions where everyone is saying that, okay, call this function, call this function, call this other function, they always show up in that particular sequence in different use cases, then there is an opportunity to write operators like SQL. So take certain inspiration from how languages got designed, especially the newer languages. You can dive deeper into domain-specific languages related information as well, but that is optional. And as I mentioned, that the first 4 years will be around, your focus should be about how compilers get implemented, how are these things getting written, and the necessity aspect of it you can learn as and when time provides and you evolve into your journey into software.